Okay, you know you can teach your child. That's not the problem. The question is, what should you teach your child? I wanted to show you what I'm working on and kind of give you an idea of how you use it and show you where to find it. So I am in the final edit process for the third grade. I can teach my child resource. These are benchmarks for learning for third grade written to you, the homeschool mom, the homeschool dad, the homeschool grandma, to equip you in order to educate your kids. So what does that mean? I have kindergarten, first grade, second grade, and almost third grade done. So you can find them at the link. They come to you in a page like this that tells you what grade you're on, and you use it as a check mark or a planner. For instance, in first grade, can you? It says, I can teach my child to follow one and two step directions. So you would use these benchmarks to use as a checkoff. If your child knows how to do this, you mark it off. If you go through the whole pack, they're anywhere between 9 and 11 pages so far per grade, and you use them first as a quick check. What does my child know? Then you use them as, okay, let me map out my school year. So these work the same for kindergarten, first grade, second grade, third grade, and eventually fifth grade. I will have them ready by fifth grade. Fair warning, I wanted you to see them today because you have the ability to purchase the whole set, kindergarten through fifth grade, before those last grades are up. And that means you get them cheaper today. So third grade looks like this. I'm just going to show you the math pages so that you see what these benchmark pages look like. So going inside the first page, and I'm still editing, you can see I still need to format this down here. The first page lets you know that third grade is about consistency. The key to building a foundation for math in third grade is consistency. And then there are one, two, three, four pages of things that you can teach your child. Like you can teach your child that multiplication and division are related. Skipping down over here, you can teach your child to master their multiplication facts through 12 times 12 because your kids should nail their math facts by the time they graduate high school. Okay, don't beat yourself up if your kids don't know their math facts in second grade or third grade. Just keep being consistent. But you use these benchmarks to give you confidence in teaching because you can teach your child. It's just a matter of, well, what should I teach your child? Mama, number one, focus on their heart, their attitude, and their character. That's the very first thing you do. Number two, you use benchmarks like these to give you an idea of, oh, wait, I know how to do that. So let's look at another one. If I look at that page, this is again third grade. I have kindergarten through third grade will be uploaded hopefully today. But inside here it says, I can teach my child to understand that a whole can be split into equal parts. You do that with food. You take a whole cookie or a whole pizza and you cut it in half. And now you have two pieces that when you smush them together equal a whole. You can do that. If your child already knows that, you mark it off and you're like, hey, we've got that down for third grade math. Look at this. You can teach your child to write fractions and to write them on a number line. This is the grade, third grade, where math may start to hit you kind of in the face a little bit. And so inside the third grade and now up grades, there will also be links to help you feel like a superstar when you're teaching third grade math. So one of the things, so again, this is kindergarten, first grade, second grade, third grade is going up today. One of the things that you need to master or your kids need to master in third grade is fractions. Okay, fractions. So there are, and not fractions, sorry, area and perimeter. So I put links to some of my favorite YouTube, either they're super goofy or super informative videos to help you. So when you're in these resources, not only do you see things that you should and can teach your child in that grade as a benchmark, but also links to help you with that. This right here, though, is one of the things that is the core of teaching math at any grade. You can teach your child that to be successful in math, they need to be an expert help seeker. They can ask help from a family member. Maybe it's you. Maybe it's your husband. Maybe it's your mom or the person next door. They can ask help from a math teacher, somebody that you know in your community that's really good with math. I highly recommend keeping a few mathematicians in your back pocket. I personally have three: an old neighbor, somebody that I co-taught with at a school, and one of my readers is an amazing mathematician. So when I get stuck, I go, "Hey, mathematician, I need help." YouTube is filled with amazing tutorials on how to do different kinds of math concepts. And my kids have excelled at being introduced to a concept on YouTube and then just being set free to play with that idea. And this right here is the most important thing to really start honing in third grade, is that the most important skill that you have that you need to succeed in math is your attitude. You need to have a positive attitude and be willing to learn. As long as you do that and you keep an open mind and recognize that you never say, "I can't," you say, "I can't yet, but with practice and help, I know I can." So it's the "I can't yet" that is something that needs to be nailed in third grade, because math just gets harder. So these benchmark lessons, these benchmark resources help you understand what you need to teach in any given grade. There are resources inside there. And starting in third grade, I'm also building, I'm building samples of things so that you know what kinds of things your kids need to learn, and I'm giving you examples of what they look like. So anyway, I just wanted to hop out and show you that I am working on all the sets. I have kindergarten through almost third grade done. If you follow the links in the description, number one, if I could get you to watch one thing, it would be the Holy Trinity of homeschooling. That truly is the key to everything. So, Holy Trinity of homeschooling. And then grab your set of the benchmarks. I wish that I had had these when I first started homeschooling. The way that I have put these together is, number one, with 25 years of homeschooling experience, picking apart math in the different modalities. So we've got basic algebra, we've got geometry, we've got measurements. So breaking apart math and then breaking apart English, writing, grammar, and reading. Matching that with standards, like what are the educational benchmarks that classrooms across the United States use to teach their kids, translating them into English. This is not a fun project, but I wish I had it when I first started. Translating the standards into English and then rewriting them to you. So instead of a gobbly, 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 gobbly gook, it will say things like, I can teach my child to create different kinds of writing. Writing that shows opinion, writing that shows facts, or writing just to entertain. I can teach my child to tell about stories by writing or drawing about it. I can teach my child to retell parts of a story in order. Once you see what you can teach your child written into an empowering I can statement, the world is your oyster. You've got this. You have everything that you need to teach your child successfully. The things that I want you to let go of are the strict lines in the road that say kindergarten, first grade, third grade, ninth grade. Those lines are really not there. You can't be behind in homeschool. In homeschool, the only behind is the one you're sitting on. That's it. But these benchmarks are the parameters that most kids at that age in an academic setting would be learning. So I think these are super, super valuable. Hey, Hester, I think these are super, super valuable. I hope you get a set. And I hope that they empower you to teach your kids with confidence. And if, as you're teaching things, if you bump into a topic, a subject, or a skill that you don't quite know how to handle, raise your hand and shout out in. You can message me or you can shout out here anywhere in the thread. And one of us, either me or any of, I have so many homeschooling connections. I can connect you to the pieces of information that you're looking for. So how do you solve percents? How do you find area? What's a good program for just fill in the blank? This gray hair came with a price. So anyway, that's it. I'm going to go finish third grade and get it loaded. The price will go up the second I load fourth grade. So that's coming at you in the next couple days. So right now it's as low as it ever will be. And I think that's it. Okay. Have a great day. See you later.